In this GIMP workshop, we will make a multi-layer stencil in black and white with 3 layers. If you want to follow along, you can find the download link for the image in the video description. When GIMP is open, we can open our image folder and bring our image into GIMP by drag and drop. Right-click on the layer and hit Add Alpha Channel. When we use a color photo, we first go to Colors and Desaturate. Here we choose the option which gives the most contrast. When we have our black and white image, we are going to remove the background. Go to the toolbox and activate the selection tool of your choice. I've chosen for the Path tool because it can make nice curves. This looks especially good around the hair in this portrait. Zoom in by holding the Ctrl key and rolling the mouse wheel. Click the first node. Then click the second node, hold the left mouse button down and drag the handle out to make a curve. Then let go of the mouse. Move the handle by click and drag back to its node and let go of the mouse. Then click the next node, keep the left mouse button down and drag out the handle to make the curve. Let go of the mouse. Place by click and drag the handle back to its node. With Ctrl Z we can undo one or more previous steps. When we press and hold the mouse wheel, we can, by moving the mouse, move the image. This can of course also be done with the scroll bars in case you do not work with a mouse. For the sake of the tutorial, we will now go fast forward. We make our selection around the outline of the background, so the background and not the subject is selected. When we are back at the first point, we can place the cursor over the first point and press the Ctrl key. When we see the chain icon, we can click and our path is closed. Go to View, Zoom and then Fit Image in Window to maximize the image. Click on the button Selection from Path to make our selection. Click on a random tool in the toolbox to make the path invisible. Then we go to Edit and hit Clear so the background is removed. Click on Select and hit None. Now we click 2 times on the Duplicate button at the bottom of the Layers panel to make 2 duplicates. We have 3 layers now. You can of course make as many layers as you like. Click on the New Layer button. Name it Background. Make the layer fill type white. And click OK. Press and hold the Shift key and hit the green downwards pointing arrow so this layer goes to the bottom of the layer stack. Then we press and hold the Shift key again and now we click on the eye of the top layer to make the other layers invisible. Make the top layer active. Then we go to Colors and Threshold. Here we reduce the black by sliding the arrowhead to the left. Keep in mind that the black that remains will be the black in our final image. Usually it looks best to keep some black, especially at the eyes, nose and mouth. Click OK. Click on the Select by Color tool and then in the white of the image. Now go to Edit and hit Clear to remove all the white. Back to Select now and hit None to deselect. Make this layer invisible. Make the second layer from above visible and active. Go to Colors, Threshold, and now we move the arrowhead in a way that we keep a bit more black than we did by the top layer. Click OK. Activate the Select by Color tool and click again in the white of the image. Go to Edit and hit Clear to remove it. Then to Select and hit None to remove the selection lines. Go to Colors and click on Levels. Slide the arrowhead at the output levels in a way that makes the medium gray, like so. We can always toggle the white background layer on and off to see how we're doing. Click OK. Make the second layer invisible. Make the third layer visible and active. Again to colors and threshold. Here we will add much more black, like so. Click OK. Now we will leave the white as it is. Go to colors and then to levels once more. Slide the arrowhead at the output levels to the right until we have a light gray. Again, click the white background layer on and off to see how it looks. Click OK. Press and hold the Shift key again and click on the eye of the third layer to make all the layers visible. And there it is, our three-layered stencil in black and white. I hope this helps. If that's the case, please be so kind to give it a like, maybe post a nice comment, and subscribe if you haven't done already to support my channel. Thank you very much for watching.